In this video, we're going to talk about stoichiometry and what that means. Make sure that you watch the mole ratio video before watching this video. Now, the word stoichiometry just is a fancy word for measurement of amounts. Metri means measurement, and stoichio means amount. And so stoichiometry is studying the relationships between reactants and products in terms of mass, or the amount of stuff there is. In the previous video, we learned that coefficients will tell you moles. And so that's what we're going to be able to use, our mole ratios, to help us figure out the relationship between mass of reactants and mass of products. In the diagram right here on your notes page, we can actually see that mass of A is grams, that's our unit, and we can go from mass to mole using molar mass. And once we're at mole, we can use our mole ratio, like we learned in the previous video, to go from moles of one substance to moles of another. And so finally, once we're from moles of A to moles of B, then finally we can calculate the grams of B using molar mass. And that's what we're going to be doing in this video. We're going to work the first example problem from your notes page. Use the same formula to determine how many grams of NH3 are produced if 15 grams of H2 react. Before we can do anything, we always have to make sure that our equation's balanced. We can see that there's two ends on the left and one end on the right, so it's not balanced until we put a 2, and then that's going to require us to put a 3 here. And then what I want to do is go ahead and write in my 1, even though we normally don't do that. That's just going to help me if I need to write the mole ratio for that. Now that we have that balanced, what we're going to go ahead and do is calculate. Now that we have that balanced, what we're going to do is calculate what we're looking for in this problem. 15 grams of H2 is my given, and then we're trying to solve for grams of NH3. First thing we're going to do here is we're going to write our given, which happens to be 15 grams of H2. Now, before we can get to grams of NH3 all the way over here, we've got to go back from grams to mole first. We always have to convert back to moles before we can do anything. I'm going to bring grams of H2 to the bottom, and I'm going to go back to moles of H2. One of the things we've said a lot is what number always goes by mole, and that's going to be 1. And then the number of grams per 1 mole of H2 comes from the periodic table. H is 1, and we've got 2 of them. So we're going to write 2 as our mass. So 2.0 grams for our mass on that one. Grams is going to cancel out, and that's going to leave me with moles of H2. Now, that's not what we're looking for, so we got to keep going. I'm going to bring moles of H2 to the bottom. Now, moles of H2 is not what we're looking for, so we're going to continue on. Bring moles of H2 to the bottom. And we're going to go back to moles of our desired unit. In this case, is NH3. I see mole over mole. That's my mole ratio. I like to circle that to remind me to go back up here and look for the units or the numbers for the mole ratio. So 2 moles of NH3 and then 3 moles of H2. Moles of H2 is going to cancel that, and that leaves me with moles of NH3. We're almost done, but we're not quite there yet. We're looking for grams, so I'm going to bring moles of NH3 to the bottom, and now we can go back to grams of NH3. The way we're going to do that is 1 mole of NH3 is the molar mass of grams of NH3. So N is 14, H is 1, and we've got 3 of them. That's going to be 17.0. The last thing we've got to do is multiply the top and divide by the bottom, and then we're going to have our answer. 15 times 2 times 17 divided by 2 divided by 3 comes out to 85 moles, or sorry, grams of NH3. And then we can check our significant figures. We started with 2, we finished with 2. Before you watch this next part, I want you to pause it right here, and I want you to try and solve this problem. And then you can restart the video to check your work. Before I can do anything, I've got to make sure this is balanced. I see 1H here, 2 on the right side, I'm going to make that 2. That's going to give me 2 OHs here, 2 NAs over here, and then we're balanced. Now I'm going to go ahead and write my 1 right here. Now we're going to write our given in the top left box, so 8.0 grams of H2. And then I'm going to bring grams of H2 to the bottom. Before we can do anything, we've got to go back to moles of H2. It's always 1 mole of H2 when we're trying to find grams. In this case, that happens to be 2.0 since 1 H is 1 and we've got 2 of them here. Grams is going to cancel out, and that leaves me with moles of H2. I'm going to bring moles of H2 to the bottom. And in this problem, we're trying to get to grams of NaOH. So before I can go to grams, we've got to go back to mole first. We have to use that mole ratio. Moles of NaOH. I like to circle mole over mole to remind me to go get my coefficients. We have 1 mole of H2, and then we have 2 moles of NaOH. I'm going to bring moles of H2 is going to cancel out. That leaves me with moles of NaOH, but we want grams. We're going to bring moles of NaOH to the bottom, and then we can go to grams of NaOH. We're going to look up that mass on the periodic table. Na is 23, O is 16, H is 1, and that's going to give me 40 as my mass per 1 mole. Last step is multiply the top and then divide by the bottom, and you are going to get 320 grams of NaOH as our final answer. And then we can check significant figures. We've got 2 values or 2 digits here, so 320 without a decimal point. Before you watch this example, I want you to pause the video and then try it for yourself. Before we can do anything, we're going to make sure this is balanced. When we do that, we're going to have 3 oxygens, 2 Al2O3s, and 4 Al's. I'm going to start with my given, 125 grams of O2. We're going to bring grams of O2 to the bottom. We're going to go back to moles of O2. It's always 1 mole when we're converting from grams. O is 16, but since we have 2 of them, we're going to make that 32.0. Grams is going to cancel out, and that's going to leave me with moles of O2. So moles of O2, and we're trying to get to grams of Al2O3. So before we go to grams, we've got to do moles first. Moles of Al2O3. I see a mole over mole. I'm going to circle it to get my coefficients. O2 is 3. Al2O3 is 2. Moles of O2 is going to cancel out. That's going to leave me with moles of Al2O3, but we want grams. We're going to go one more step here. Moles of Al2O3 to grams of Al2O3. And then we're going to look up on the periodic table the mass. And that mass happens to be 102. And then the last thing we're going to do is multiply the top, divide by the bottom, and your answer is going to be 265.625, but we want to round that to significant figures. We've got 3 here, and we're going to use the first 3, but because that last digit right here in the 6, our final answer is going to be 266 grams of Al2O3. For this last example, this one's going to have a different conversion that you may not be used to, but it's really not that much more difficult to use. Using the following reaction, how many liters of H2O will be produced if 150 grams of CH4 is reacted at STP? This time we're going to liters instead of grams. So anytime you see STP, that stands for standard temperature and pressure, and that's just a specific temperature and pressure that chemists have agreed upon. And at that temperature and pressure, 1 mole of any gas is going to be 22.4 liters. And we're going to be able to use that conversion here. Before we can begin, we need to make sure that our equation's balanced. I see 1C, 1C. I've got 4 H's, but only a 2 over here. So we're going to make that 2. That's going to give me 2 O's, and 2 O's is 4. So finally, we're going to write in our numbers, and we should be good there. We're going to start with our given, 150 grams of CH4. We're going to bring grams of CH4 to the bottom. We still have to go back to moles before we can do anything. We always have to convert back to moles. So CH4, 1 mole of that is going to be our molar mass here. So 12 plus 4 is going to be 16. Grams cancels out, leaves me with moles of CH4. We're looking for liters of H2O. So we got to keep going. I'm going to bring moles of CH4 to the bottom. And we're going to go to moles of whatever we're looking for. So in this case, that happens to be H2O. I see mole over mole. I like to circle that. I'm going to go find my coefficients. 1 for CH4, 2 for water. Moles is going to cancel out, and that leaves me with moles of H2O. But we're looking for liters here. So therefore, I got to keep going. I'm going to bring moles of H2O. And we're going to write whatever we're going to. So before we've been going to grams, but this time we're going to liters. So instead of grams, I'm going to write liters of H2O. And since this problem says we're at standard temperature and pressure, we can use this conversion right here. 1 mole of H2O is 22.4 liters. Moles of H2O is going to cancel out. Leaves us with liters of water. Now we can multiply the top. And we can divide by the bottom, and then your answer is going to be 420 liters of H2O. And then we check sig figs. We've only got 2 digits here, and so 2 down here. That's our answer.